Hey everyone, this is Pastor Anthony Nix coming at you with another weekly devotional from Anderson Seventh-day Adventist Church in Anderson, Indiana. And the title of our devotional today is The Compassion of Jesus. One thing that most people can agree on is that Jesus is arguably the most compassionate human to ever live. And when we talk about being compassionate to other people, Jesus is often referenced that we should use the model of his life to be compassionate. The fact is that Jesus came to this world to be the servant of man's necessity. The scriptures say in Matthew chapter 8, verse 17, that the things were fulfilled in Jesus' life were fulfilling the word of the Lord through the prophet Isaiah, who said, "He took our sicknesses and removed our diseases." Jesus did this so that he could tend to the needs of humanity. He came to remove your load of disease and your misery of sin. It was his mission to bring humanity to complete restoration, back to the Garden of Eden, to the purpose for which God created us. He came to give you health and peace, and Jesus to restore in you the image of God. The reason for which people sought the help of Jesus were many, but none who came to Jesus went away unhelped. From Jesus flows streams of healing power. In body and mind and soul, humans were made whole again. Jesus' work is not restricted to any time or place. This compassion knew no limit. Jesus' work was on such a large scale that no building in Israel was large enough to receive the multitudes that thronged to him. On the green hills of Galilee, or by the seashore, in the synagogues, and in every place where the sick could be brought to him was to be found his hospital. In every city, every town, every village through which Jesus passed, he laid his hand upon sick ones and healed them. Wherever their hearts were ready to receive his message, he comforted them with the assurance of their heavenly Father's love. All day he tended to those who came to him, and in the evening he gave attention to those who needed support for their families. Jesus carried the weight of responsibility for the salvation of humanity. He knew that unless there was a change in the principles and purposes of human beings, all would be lost. This was the weight on his soul, and no one could appreciate the weight that rested upon him. In this manner, he walked alone. Every day, Jesus met trials and temptations. Every day, he was brought into contact with evil, and he witnessed the power of evil upon those whom he was seeking to bless and to save. Yet, he did not fail, nor was he ever discouraged. Jesus was always patient and cheerful, and the sick cheered him as a messenger of life and peace. He saw the need of humanity. He saw the need of children and young people. And to every single person, he gives the invitation, "Come to me." As he passed through the towns and the cities, Jesus was like a life-giving current, diffusing life and joy to everyone. Jesus still does that today. Jesus wants to heal you of the things that weigh on your life. Jesus wants to take the load that bogs you down in life, and he wants to carry it for you. Jesus wants to bring unspeakable joy to your life, but you gotta come to him. Jesus will never force himself on you. And once you decide to come to him, you will see that Jesus will heal you of every load and every sickness that plagues your life. The invitation is still for you today. Jesus still says to you, "Come to me." Will you come to him? God bless you. Have a great day.